Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to Let's Play Lost Kingdoms. We've almost got all of the legendary gods, but we need one more, and for that, we're going to have to go to Yawlwok. Now, we have definitely prepared. The only element here is fire, so I had to bring a large selection of my best water type Oh, am I kidding? It's just Dragon Knights. The whole thing. Couple of crystal roses, but really the majority is just dragon. I'd set off the blue dragon in there too, but if I remember right, I don't use him actually for the rest of the game. If you're wondering what he looks like, well, you remember the dragon with the orb last episode? He shows up and then your cards reappear. That's about it. So, this place is bright as hell and also has some large monsters in it. Yeah, just like the Earth Temple had the zombie dragons, the Fire Temple here gonna have regular old red dragons. And of course they have just as much HP as they would under any other circumstance, so they're going to be fairly tough. Dragonites really are the best thing to use against them though. They deal a ton of damage. And of course they have water elements, so why would you use anything else? If you've been collecting a lot of Dragon Knights to this point, you'll probably have quite the sizable collection too. This is the Land of Fire. The middle of the volcano here with the plume 2 feet to our left, currently spraying lava. This is the Land of Fire? Alright. I'll take your word for it. And hey, I mean, you're right here. I'm glad the search is over. Come on with us, we'll go. Oh, okay. I get it. I help you, you help me. Yeah, alright, it's fine. So we've got to find the source of the black water in this land, and we've got to put a stop to it. By the way, those fire spumes will hurt you if you touch them. So, Fairy, you're in the middle of a volcano. This doesn't seem like a very good course of discussion here. But yeah, as it's mentioning, there are certain card advances you can do. If you summon multiple of the same card— oh, you tricky son of a bitch. If you summon multiple of the same card at the same time, almost always three, it can come up with a combo, so to speak. Most of them are just three trap cards summoned on the field will do something special. Usually the something special is not nearly as good as the trap cards themselves. And you've got to prevent the trap cards from going off long enough to do this, while simultaneously making sure that the enemy remains within the area of effect. And this rock isn't conspicuous at all. I think that's an Ifrit, by the way. It's just, it's not very tough, it just likes to teleport around. The Great Demon's also not super tough, but the two-hit combo is difficult to interrupt, it deals decent damage, and it heals them whenever they hit you, so the more you get hit, the harder it's going to be to kill them. Kinda sucks, but there it is. So we've got to find a way to stop the black water. There looked like some black water behind that rock there. But, I don't think we can get there yet. We've got to find a way to get around to that water so we can get it done. Also, a note about this level real quick. It does have a habit of tinting everything orange, and I do mean everything. So, when we summon, say, an ice golem, all of a sudden it's a golden golem. Aw, oh, I love the look of that. If it looked like that all the time, I might use it more often. But yeah, ice golems are very effective here, because obviously everything's going to be fire, but because more than that, everything is pretty much one-shotted by the ice golem, save for, like, the dragon and the boss. So they're actually useful, unlike, say, I don't know, in the Earth Temple, when things have more HP, you're not really going to be able to use them to get past there. Or the the Earth equivalent of it. You know what I mean. But of course, there are tons of treasure chests just hanging around this giant, fiery deathscape. So we gotta collect all we can, but since you already need at least 20 cards, well, I mean, let's be real, you probably already have most of the stuff that you're gonna need. And also, again, golden golem, and that summoning animation is fantastic, the triple take. I didn't really feel like dealing with great demons though, so ice golem away. How are we walking here? I mean, I know, it's... how are we summoning creatures from cards? How are we doing all sorts of things? But... like... this is a volcano. Like an active volcano. We're standing on... what is probably very... recently hardened rock. Speaking of recently hardened rock... the gods created the world in the beginning, so we actually did the levels in the reverse order. You could get that story in the correct order if you played the levels all... oh, thanks, little fairy. That's actually sort of helpful to know. You know where this demon fox might... oh, for the love of God. You just had to show up, didn't you? Had to show up to ruin the party. Luckily, dragon knights don't actually deal enough damage to stagger the dragons into invincibility frames, so you can still cycle them pretty quickly. Weirdly enough, even though it has a lower attack power, the crystal rose will more easily stagger enemies like the dragon here. So if you fire the crystal rose at it, it'll actually be invulnerable for a lot longer time. In this case, it's invulnerable forever now, because it's dead. Here we go, some water, finally. You know, I don't think some water would actually go awry here. To toss a bit of water into the place, you got... oh, for the love... okay, cut this. Cut this fight. We're not fighting another dragon on camera. You all get the gist. Dragon knights are good. You know, a little bit of water might not go awry here, though. You know, it's kind of really inhospitable otherwise. But I suppose if it's a land of fire creatures, they're really not going to be too hot about the water, so to speak. Also, it's really hard to spot chests here. Like, oh hey, a kitty trap. Somebody mentioned that just earlier. A red fairy, maybe. A chimera. And a berserker. Okay, so nothing we're going to use. But... I don't know. I lost my train of thought from earlier. Okay, this fairy knows where the demon fox is. Good. So as soon as you walk in here, immediately the random encounter will begin. This is actually the boss fight of the stage, the demon fox. Demon fox is... kind of a chump. He has one attack, really, that he'll ever use, and that attack is... firing those homing fireballs at you. They're pretty much impossible to dodge, especially with the movement penalty inflicted by the terrain. But he has a habit of, if you're right in front of him, just flinging more fireballs while you're still invincible. And dragon knights deal a lot of damage to him. So, if you get hit, you're pretty much just going to get knocked down, get back up, and then after you've taken your, what, 30-something damage, you're just going to whack him in the face again. Easy. You have a couple of Krakens, this fight is a complete pushover, even if you don't have Krakens. But, as you can see, running out of cards is a bit of an issue, so if you have the blue dragon by this point in this level, you might want to bring it along. Just because if you do run out of cards, that's obviously a pretty bad thing, and the blue dragon does restore your entire deck, and all of your HP. Which is broken as hell. If you have one other card restoration mechanism, you just use that next to get the blue dragon back and you're in business. How is a fire creature of the golden fox or the red fox summoning that water anyway? I mean, it's a fire creature. You can see it right here, because it's actually the card we get. It is the single best fire creature that is not the Phoenix, because this is actually the deal elemental damage to all wood cards. So how was it summoning demon water? Or whatever. In any case. We also get the Golden Phoenix, which is unfortunately largely useless. For as long as this card is on the field, it will take all damage that the player will take instead of them. Which means if you don't get hit, the Golden Phoenix really isn't terribly useful. It's a lot of life, but recovery cards almost just work better. So, take it for what it's worth. We got a couple of fairies to turn into Alexander. We're so close to 100, but we're not quite there. We are, however, very close to the adventure. In fact, I think we've only got one more stage to go through. It is a doozy, though. So I'll see you folks next time when we head back to the temple, and then finally, to the last level of the game. This has been PA. See you all then.